Der Kunstraum Niederösterreich verleiht seit 2007 den H13 Niederösterreich Preis für Performance. Otto Kraus und Milan Lovischka sind die diesjährigen Preislaureaten mit der Performance Furry, wo sie teilweise schwierige gesellschaftspolitische Themen verkleidet in Plüsch und Pelz den Betrachtern vermitteln.
So my journey has been quite a long one. I started as a dancer since very early age. I danced since I think I was able to stand on my feet and went through all the possible opportunities that were around me doing, being part of different kind of disco groups and folklore dances in Slovakia, and yeah, I just did everything that was possible, and somehow I felt that this should be my profession, but also it was not really very much appreciated by my parents or many other people, so I besides that decided that I would like to also study something else, and the education was always important for me personally and for my family, so I graduated from psychology while doing a conservatory in Prague parallel to that, and then I spent 1 year still at SMDO, which is a school for new dance development in Amsterdam. So it's a combination of science and arts in my case, I would say.
Ja, ich habe Bühnenbild studiert auf der Universität für angewandte Kunst. Und wir haben eigentlich vor unserem Diplom auch schon ein paar kleine Arbeiten zusammen gemacht und dann eben mein Diplom zusammen. Das war eigentlich so die erste größere Arbeit zusammen. Und das war eigentlich eine Auseinandersetzung mit Raum und einer performativen Handlung. Es war eine durational Arbeit auch. Zur Rollenverteilung, die löst sich interessanterweise immer mehr auf oder ist eigentlich auch immer unterschiedlich von Arbeit zu Arbeit. Also ich stelle natürlich viel von den Objekten und Kostümen her, aber die quasi Designentscheidungen oder praktische Entscheidungen fällen wir eigentlich durchwegs zusammen.
Well, it's definitely important in our work to have a connection to the audience that goes beyond spectating. I think that, yeah, this kind of typical theater situation we don't really like so much, even we do it from time to time, but we like to be a little bit closer to the audience and we definitely like to engage them. And yeah, I would not say that there are tricks how to do that, but there are ways, yeah, how to do that. I think what is really important is to invite them in some clear way that they know what is expected of them, why is that happening, and they should feel they actually want to do it themselves. It's really kind of tricky when you put them into a situation that they have no choice whatsoever. But we have done that as well. In a performance actually where we play musical chairs with the audience on stage, and that is on purpose a sort of an experience that they can't really escape easily, but that's part of the fun of the piece. So you can even play with that, but it's necessary to think of how to engage them, and it's always different.
bei diesem Thema, glaube ich, kam sehr zugute, dass wir uns auseinandergesetzt haben mit quasi einer der entwaffnenden Natur von Niedlichkeit. Also wir haben auch in unserer Recherche uns auseinandergesetzt mit wissenschaftlichen Papers, psychologischen Arbeiten zum Thema Niedlichkeit und dass quasi die Auseinandersetzung mit niedlichen Bildern, zum Beispiel Tierfotos von Kätzchen und Hunden, dass es dazu Studien gibt, dass die eine gewisse Offenheit in den Betrachterinnen, in den Betrachtern erzeugen, die dann in weiterer Folge auch verwendet wird für politische Messages. Und ich glaube, das ist eben ein wesentlicher Teil, den wir uns hier auch zugute also angeeignet haben, um auch eine Botschaft zu transportieren über einen spielerischen Aspekt, über Niedlichkeit.
Yeah, but first and foremost, it started with the material. Yeah. It started with the interest in plush and fell, plush and fur, which came actually, it was an idea for a completely other project that involves a lot of high-tech technologies and that we have been working on with some scientists from three different countries, and we hope to continue if we get funding that we need for that. And then we decided that actually it's a great topic to do a performance of its own without involving these researchers and these technologies. And then we try to search for some kind of connection to the society, which we found in this subculture of furry fandom, which are people that likes to dress up in anthropomorphic costumes of different kind of animals. They meet at conventions and have fun being all these kind of great, crazy creatures. It's very cute, yeah. And then the politics, the psychology, what else? Yeah, social media and technologies. At the end, actually, which was a really funny thing, we ended up involving technologies, even we did not want at the beginning. Yeah, but then, yeah, we had this live stream. We tweeted in the performance. We use a robotic ball in the performance. So there are all these kind of aspects of technologies. I mean, in performance art, this is actually sort of a trouble. We sort of don't like exhibitions of performance art that feature videos of the performances, but that's the documentation, so it's really hard. I think that it's the best to do a performance, even if it is some kind of retrospective. I mean, I think that Marina Abramović did a very good job with her artist is present at MoMA few years ago, where she actually hired performers who were doing the works through all the 3 months of the exhibition, and she herself was sitting there for 3 months. I think that was definitely one of the best examples how to do a good exhibition about performance art.
Die Köpfe kommen ja eigentlich auch von der Auseinandersetzung mit dem Thema Niedlichkeit oder Cuteness. Es kam eigentlich in einem Text von Daniel Harris, der Cute oder Cuteness als erster so als ästhetische Kategorie definiert hat und in weiterer Folge eigentlich daraus abgeleitet hat, dass die ultimative Form von niedlichen Objekten oder Plüschtieren oder Mode, dass wenn man quasi alle Aspekte ins Extrem treibt, kommen knuddelbare, plüschige Bälle heraus, also furry love balls.
I think that's still related to the same things, and that is a cuteness and also furry fandom, but now it is more in, because cuteness is something else in the Western art and something else in Asian art, where it has its own term and its own economy. Actually, it's kawaii in Japan, that is related to this cute culture of manga and anime and video games, and in Western art it's the best represented, I think, by Walt Disney movies. But it's different kind of aesthetic, talking about the same things. So that's why we sort of decided to be this kind of hybrid creatures. We are not anything specific, it's not one or the other, it's a mixture of all. Even like when we talked to the people from furry fandom, like what kind of furries are we going to be, it was just clear that we are a hybrid of everything. A little bit of bunny, a little bit of squirrel, a little bit of, I don't know, unicorn, or we just took parts from everything or many, many things and created our own.
Otto Krause und Milan Lovischka arbeiten in außergewöhnlicher Intensität mit unkonventionellen Formaten und Strategien und lassen sich von spartenübergreifenden Forschungsprozessen inspirieren. Zwischen ästhetischer Opulenz und Reduktion entstehen körperlich intensive, atmosphärische, imaginative Arbeiten, deren Konzepte Aspekte von Populärkultur und Wissenschaft zusammenführen, wie Superhelden, Comics, Psychologie, Pornografie, Biologie, neue elektronische Medien, Religion, Filmwissenschaft oder Philosophie. Also es ist ein sehr breites Spektrum und ich freue mich, dass das so ein interessanter, spannender Abend war. Ja, und der große Höhepunkt ist dann, ihr bekommt natürlich unsere Trophäe, den H13-Preis. Bravo!